today is Are You OK Day, a national day dedicated to mental health and reminding people to ask just that, are you OK? Every year in Australia, one in five adults will experience mental health problems. Suicide is the leading cause of death in our men aged between 15 and 44. One in seven primary school kids and one in four adolescents experience mental health issues, with 65% of those adolescents not seeking help. A simple conversation can make all the difference, and someone who knows only too well is founder of the Resilience Project, Hugh van Kylenberg. Hugh, good morning. Welcome back to Today.
Thanks, Georgie.
Are you OK? Three simple words. We really have embraced that. We're hearing that message. But are we really listening?
Yes. Look, I'm very passionate about this day, and the reason I'm passionate is because I had the opportunity to ask someone once if they're okay, and I didn't take that opportunity, and I live with that regret. You know, his name was Luke. He was a beautiful man. He was a scorer at my cricket club, an autistic man. He was a wonderful person. You can see him on the screen there. One of my favourite stories about Luke, one of his first days at the club, he came over to me and said, "Hey, where do I get one of those T-shirts that you're wearing, you know, our club T-shirts?" And I said, "I've got one in my bag. I'll give you one after training." After the game. And after the game, I was doing a presentation. He realised what was happening and he got so excited. He ran up the front and he stood next to me and he took his top off and just stood there. He was just so excited. And I gave him his T-shirt, he put it on and I said, "Luke, we're going out for dinner. Do you want to join us?" And he said, "I can't." And I said, "Why not?" He said, "I'm going to Mum and Dad's house. I'm going to show him my new T-shirt."
Oh, beautiful.
He was a terrific person. And with Luke, you know, 1st of June every year, you'd set your clock to it, he'd give me a call. "Hugh, how long until cricket season?" I'd say, "Luke, it's 4 months away." He'd say, "That's a long time. Bye." And he'd hang up. 1st of July, "How long till cricket season?" "It's 3 months." "That's a long time." "Bye," and he'd hang up. I got a phone call from him 4 years ago, mid-September, and the question was, he said, how long till cricket season? I said, "Look, it's a couple of weeks away." And he said, "That still feels like a long time to me." And there's a bit of a pause, and I remember thinking, is he okay? And I didn't ask him, and I hung up the phone. Well, so he hung up the phone, and I thought, I'll see him in a couple of weeks. And I got a phone call from my club president a few days later to say Luke had taken his life. So I had the opportunity. I work in mental health and even I didn't think to do it. Well, I thought to do it, but I thought, oh, no, he'll be fine. Mm. That's why I'm passionate about this question.
Understandably so. You've also spent a lot of time with AFL player Jack Watts through some very turbulent times. Tell us about that.
Well, this is the thing with are you OK? It's a great question, but I think the really important thing is if you're going to ask someone are they OK, if you want to get somewhere in the conversation, you've got to be willing to make yourself vulnerable. So I learned a lot off the situation I had with Luke. A few years later, I'm working with Jack Watts and the controversies broke and I happened to be at the club with him the very next day after the controversies, which destroyed his relationship, ruined his relationship with his partner. And I sat there with him and I said, "Are you okay?" And he said, "Yeah, I'll be fine, I'll get through it." He clearly wasn't. And with Luke fresh in my mind, I'm thinking, no, be vulnerable. And I said, "Mate, do you know what? I've actually stuffed up in a relationship. I've made a really bad mistake in the past, which cost me a really special relationship. I've been there." And because I made myself vulnerable, he automatically felt comfortable to talk.
Aussie men, particularly sportsmen, are not good at showing vulnerability, and we've got to encourage them.
And Jack is a beautiful person. He's so in touch with his emotions and everything, but even he found it hard to say, "Yeah, I am struggling," until I made myself vulnerable. So ask the question, "You're okay?" and then be willing to actually make yourself vulnerable to say, "Yeah, do you know what, you know, I know what it feels like to struggle," that kind of stuff, because it really helps.
This has been a very dark week and I want to talk to you about Danny Frawley, because you knew him and we now know that his life ended in a very, very tragic way. He was vocal about his battle with mental health.
Yeah.
And I can see this is still very raw.
Yeah, yeah. So Danny was an amazing support for the Resilience Project and me in the early days when I started off out of nowhere. I grew up watching Danny Frawley, and he's like a hero of mine. And one day I'm sitting at home and I get a phone call, number I didn't recognise. "G'day mate, my name's Danny Frawley, I've heard what you're doing." I don't know where he got my number, I think he got it off Wayne Schwoss, who's a wonderful man in this space of mental health. And he said, I just want to let you know I love what you're doing, I'm going to come and hear you speak one day. And I thought, that's amazing. And I hung up the phone and thought, well, that probably won't happen, but that's lovely. And about 3 weeks later, I'm doing a parent talk at a school in Melbourne. And I'm 5 minutes in and Danny Frawley walks in with two of his daughters and he sat there with a big smile on his face and afterwards he said, "Mate, what you're doing is just brilliant. You've got to keep going. It's a really special fight you're involved in." And it's been a pretty full-on week. It really has been. I've been reading so much more about the suicide and the T-shirt I'm wearing today is to acknowledge also on this very topic that our First Nations, the people of our First Nation, they have a real, we've got a real issue on our hand, and it's an academic, and it's something that we are not talking about enough as a country. But the suicide rate amongst Aboriginal people in this country is terrifying at the moment. We need to start talking about it. But Danny Frawley, a wonderful man who has... I just feel privileged I actually knew him. I really do.
If there's one thing you could impart upon our audience this morning, what would it be when it comes to mental health? Is it that we're all leading these crazily busy lives and we're not listening? We're hearing, but we're not listening?
Oh, I could go on for ages about this. I think, for me, it's to understand that we all have our own story. We're all going through struggles. We've just released a podcast called The Imperfects, and it's to actually get this message across. We interview with my friend Ryan Shelton, a comedian. The two of us talk to really famous Australians about their struggles, people you look at and think their life must be perfect. Imagine being that person. We had Missy Higgins last week, and she was just incredible. Jack Watts, actually, I spoke about before. He speaks very candidly about his struggles, his depression as a result of the mistakes he's made. No one's perfect. Mm. We all stuff up in life. We all make decisions that we look back and regret. But we've got to understand that we're all human. And I think that's the message to understand, is that we're all human and it's okay to make mistakes, but we've got to be there for each other. We've got to connect and ask the question, are you okay, especially on a day like today?
Well said, Hugh. And today could be the day that you are really making a difference to someone's life. Congratulations on your podcasts. Obviously, if people want to know more about your talks around the country, the Resilience Project, they can go online and find out more. Hugh, it's always a great pleasure. Thank you.
Thanks for having me, Julie.
You're doing extraordinary work.
Hi, YouTubers. I'm Davina Smith. Well, click here to keep watching Great Nine videos and subscribe to our channel here for lots more news, analysis and exclusive content. For breaking news, see you at 9news.com.au.